Hello Libras, I'm Christy. You're watching Tiny Turtle Tarot, and this is your reading for the next 6 months. As always, if anything I say resonates or you feel it's going to resonate, please let me know by liking and subscribing. Let's get on with your reading. What's happening for you beautiful Libras next? You've got the Ten of Swords. The Knight of Cups, the Six of Pentacles, and the Nine of Wands. I'll explain what these cards mean and then I'll kind of clarify them so we can see why they've come out for you specifically. The Ten of Swords is a beautiful card of, the word that just came through is redemption. Might be like a redemption arc coming in for you in the next 6 months, but it makes sense because Ten of Swords is like the minor arcana of the Death card, which is rising from the ashes and like Phoenix rising. And Ten of Swords is the only way's up. Things are only going to get better. So whatever you've been through in the last 6 months, if it wasn't ideal, if it's not felt very nice, it's getting better in the next 6 months. And I feel like that's an understatement, but I'm going to keep it there for now, that things are getting better from here on out. Knight of Cups energy is very romance energy, very romantic, somebody very love orientated around you. Like if you're in a relationship, somebody is showering you with affection. Somebody is obsessed with you, but in a healthy way, and like obsessed with making you aware of how obsessed they are with you, is the energy. I'm just very, very reciprocal. And it's funny I said that because now I'm looking at the Six of Pentacles. Six of Pentacles, very reciprocal, very fair, equal give and take. If this is to do with your relationships, you're making sure that you are giving and receiving in your friendships and in your social circle. It's just as if you're not overly, if in the past you have given a lot of energy and helped and volunteered your time to help others, if you've done that to an unhealthy degree, that's not the case in the next 6 months. Any way in which you're helping those around you, the people that you're there for are there for you as well, basically. You've got a tight group of people, I'm feeling, and they're all going to be there for you as much as you're there for them, basically. Nine of Wands, also protective energy towards the end of the year. I'll clarify now. I'll clarify and see why these cards are here. Clarify the Ten of Swords. Page of Pentacles. So to do with like your career path and your job and your work, your income, the only way is up. Things are getting better. There's an opportunity in particular coming in that you're gonna have to choose. I'm not getting you're choosing between two opportunities. You're gonna choose about how you go about this opportunity when you get it, because I feel as if you can take it and deal with it as others would. Or you're going to put your own little spark on it. You're going to put your own little touch on it. And you're going to make it work for you. For a lot of you, I just... It's just this feeling of... I'm going to use this. That's the word that keeps coming in. That's the sentence that keeps coming through. I'm going to use this. Whereas others would be like, oh yeah, I've got this opportunity to do this. Yeah, it'll be alright. You're like, light bulb, I can make this work for me. That's the energy. You're making something work for you. You're seeing, like, with the Ten of Swords is like, what have I got to lose? I might as well try. Like, you're gonna have an epiphany moment, an idea, and it's gonna work out. And it might be like, for a lot of you, it definitely is something like off, something different or off the normal path. like you might have a very normal job or a very normal thing, but there's a way that you're twisting some type of opportunity, or like Page of Pentacles is an opportunity basically being handed to you, given to you, but it's what you do with it. I'm feeling what you're doing with it is going to be special. Clarify the Knight of Cups. The Fool card. So the Fool is the start of a new journey, and it can be very nerve-wracking. So to do with love, you're entering a new path in love that you've never been on before. So if you are in a long-term relationship already, you're just stepping something up, or you're furthering a commitment and you've never been this committed to someone, or you've never, you're taking the next step with someone in some way. And if you're single, it looks like for a lot of you, you definitely have someone new coming in with that Fool card. And it's going to be nerve-wracking because I feel like this is going to be a lot more authentic, where you're actually yourself. When I was meditating on your cards, I was really getting this energy of you and this person just chatting to each other and saying things like, you would never say these things to other people. That's what I was getting, because I was just feeling like I was getting all these stories come through, things that I would never tell anybody. And I feel like that's what you're going to be doing. You're going to be telling someone things you would be embarrassed usually to say, except you're not going to be embarrassed to say it to this person, and vice versa. Clarify the Six of Pentacles. The Chariot. There's some type of travel, but it's reciprocated. So maybe if you and someone else lives at a distance, this person travels just as much as you do, and vice versa, to come and see each other. It's very fair, very like, yeah, because the Chariot's about travel, and then the Six of Pentacles is about fairness and equally shared responsibilities, or whatever you'd call it. And if this isn't about, maybe that's not about what this is about, maybe this is more about career or job, or in the next 6 months, there's just something here where your travel isn't going to be, maybe your work is like wanting you to travel or something. Or they're paying for you to travel. If you drive around a lot and they don't pay for like your fuel or your mileage or whatever it's called, like they're going to start paying. Pulling their end of the bargain. I don't know. I don't know why it's coming through. But there's also travel. Chariot, success, it's travel, it's fast movement. It's also multitasking. Some of you are also working on something on the side. And I'm saying this and I'm doubting myself, but at the same time I'm feeling more and more sure about it. Random pickup. Some of you are like writing a book, or you're doing something, but it's like in a spare moment, like you're chipping away at it, but nobody knows about it. Nobody knows, and it's beautiful because you're not doing it for you know, social, you're not doing it to be like, oh, I'm writing a book, I'm doing this. You're not doing it for that. You're doing it because you're enjoying having your own little project on the side that's special to you. This can be successful because you're enjoying it. I know I keep saying that, but because you like it, it's going to work out. People are going to feel the joy that you've put into something. They're going to feel that you enjoyed making something. Clarify the Nine of Wands. Some of you I'm also getting that is you trying for a baby or something. And so there's a really funny spin on that, because I'm like, you're going to enjoy making this. Like, I don't know. There's something kind of... And because the Fool card, and I said for those of you that are already in long-term relationships, you're taking a new start, a new step. It's quite nerve-wracking. Like, I feel like there's something here about maybe your furthering commitment is having a baby with someone or something. Because that would be quite nerve-wracking, I'm assuming. The Star card and the Four of Swords to clarify the Nine of Wands. Nine of Wands, I said about you, there's a protective energy around you at the end of the year. With the Star card, that's wish fulfillment. That's also major healing. This is the major arcana for healing. So with that, when you are healed, you're going to feel like, oh gosh, I must protect myself now. I'm healed. I don't want to be hurt. That's basically what I'm feeling like. I'm getting a hedgehog energy, and I just feel like you're going to be a little bit spikier from now on, but in a good way. Like, you're protecting yourself with your spikes, because on the inside you're so open, and you're open to love, and you're very empathetic, and I just feel like you've healed your heart genuinely in a way that you're not letting anybody get to you. And I don't know, it feels, I don't know if I'm explaining it right, but it feels actually genuinely good, because usually I'd be like, don't protect yourself from the world and don't protect yourself from all the good stuff, but it feels like you're only protecting yourself from the negative, which is good. You also had the Four of Swords, so Four of Swords and the Star card, these are both healing. You're healing the big stuff, and you've healed the little stuff too. I don't know why I'm seeing bricks, and it's like, the Star card is the bricks. You've healed the bricks of the wall, and then the Four of Swords is the cracks in between the bricks. You've glued it all together, you've healed the cracks in between, the little itty bitty details, the things you didn't know you needed to heal, you've healed. And now you're like, self-preservation, I must protect myself. It's like you're new, it's like you're born again, and then you're so healed and you're so, you're feeling so good that you then want to protect how good you feel. But it's good, I like it. I'm gonna wrap your reading up here. Thank you so much for watching. If anything I said resonated or you feel it will, please let me know by liking and subscribing, and I'll see you next Tuesday for Tiny Turtle Tarot Tuesdays.